Good afternoon, everybody. This is Doc Stab back with another episode of XCom Enemy Unknown. Wow, we had a bit of a rough time in France last episode. Let's take a look at how we did, shall we? Let's just get in game here real quick. See where we are. Oh yeah, that's right. Operation Severed Whisper. Lost Squatty Snot Miname to a critical shot from a floater. And Squatty Joe Aberano, who was our only assault, I believe, got lost. Yeah, because I couldn't control my explosives around a car. Actually, that's the second. Arthur Leroy and Joe Aberano. Fully half of our casualties are due to me mixing up the role of explosives and cars, and how they don't really play very nicely together. So, hoist a drink for the fallen and see what we've got left. We have two medics, a heavy, and two snipers. Looking at mission control, looks like in 2 days our satellite uplink will be complete, and so will our experimental warfare research. Day after that, we're going to get some new grist for the mill with fresh rookies arriving at HQ, and then a few days after that, we're going to get our new satellites so we can try and pull back the panic situation. We'll get a quick satellite look at the globe. Japan has bailed. Egypt and South Africa are not particularly happy with us. Yeah, things are not going well for the Earth at the moment, but all is not lost.
Contact
not yet.
Detected.
Okay, we have an intact UFO landing in Nigeria. So at the moment, what they've got to set up with is Kim Cook, Corporal Malik, Brian Ring, and Nick Andrea. Let's adjust some loadout here. Get Nick a med kit. You know, ordinarily I wouldn't like to send two medics, but the way things are going, I don't know. Maybe two medics isn't enough. Let's stick with his default team for now. Just launch the mission. Now, unlike a crash site, no aliens will have been killed.
Strike one. Prepare
so, there's going to be heavier resistance here. Operation First
Tiers. We're going to be dropping you deep in the Nigerian interior for the next operation.
That doesn't sound good.
Reports indicate the UFO set down in a sparsely populated area. We need to stay sharp and eliminate the invaders.
Now, the nice thing is, if I can manage to wipe out all the bad guys, an intact UFO is going to have a lot more salvage for me to sell, to study. So that's got that going for us. Looks like we got woods in the daytime. New hapless complement of individuals here.
Roger that, Big Sky. Strike one, you are
going
to deploy.
UFO is.
Approach with extreme caution. Current enemy status at the site is unknown.
Kim Cook, you go up here where you can't do any damage to us. We've got a whole lot of half cover, but not... You know, I kind of like this spot for Nick. We can dash the Varsha Malik all the way up here. She didn't make any enemy contact, so... Let's get our sniper. Get our sniper up to this tree here. We'll throw Cook and Nick onto Overwatch real quick. Now, if a patrol wanders into us, that's in some ways ideal. Let's see if we can find a likely spot for Varsha.
Heading there
it's
now.
Probably the best I can do. Move Kim Cook up behind her.
Will do.
Yes, just stay there. At least Cook, despite her performance, and I blame her, even though that was pretty much all me.
Already there.
Blowing up the car with my bad tactics. She did get a promotion, which means that when she shoots, whether she hits or not, she's going to provide a to-hit bonus with her holo targeting at whatever she shoots at. So I got that going for me, which is nice. Alright, we're going to move up to here. Let's get her into heavy cover. Varsha can dash to there or can just hang out and swing out of this wing. Watch her.
Scanning.
Ideally, if we don't run into any serious resistance, I guess I'd kind of like to get Brian
on it
with a sniper rifle up really high, so I can get a vantage point on everything. And there's no reason not to rush him at this point, to dash with him.
Roger that.
Because he's not going to be able to move and shoot anyway.
I feel, Commander. I think I heard something.
Alright, sounds like we've got some... Oh! Well, how about that? There's the UFO. Let's get Brian up here. I don't like the distance from the UFO for switching to the pistol, so I think we're just going to approach this side. Get Cook
moving
into this light
location.
Cover. Just kind of reposition around. The lack of heavy cover on the approach is not ideal. Let's change the camera so we can get a better look at what we're seeing here.
I'm rolling.
Malik up this way. Watch her.
Aye, aye.
And Nick is way out of position. Start moving him up this way.
Moving.
Alright, I feel a little bit better now that we know where the UFO is. Yeah, they're right there through that door.
I heard something.
It's not a... Whoa, okay.
Enemy in sight.
They just kind of popped in from nowhere, didn't they? I think we got a little bit of a glitch there, but it seems to have worked in our advantage. Alright, let's see what he's got. He's got a 35% chance for that one. Or 65% chance of hitting that one. It would be really nice just to have a shotgun right about now. Kim Cook has an 80% chance of finishing that one off. I figured even if she'd missed... holo targeting would have worked out for her pretty well. 48% is about as good as I can expect. Varsha, unfortunately, best I can do with her is to provide some smoke cover.
Cover going out.
Kim's probably going to get hit anyway. I didn't realize they both had the flank on her.
They're trying to pull back.
Oh no.
You just lost one.
Help! Now, damn it, now!
Wow, another crit from a floater. Ugh, such bad luck. It's a good panic, though.
Roger, I've got my eyes on.
Yeah, I don't think tactically there was a whole lot else I could have done differently there.
Moving.
A little bit of karma there from...
Eyes on target.
Oh my goodness. Let's get a reaction shot from Brian here.
He's down.
One down. Okay, 33% shots. I'll have to take it. Not gonna do.
Damn it, enemy is still alive.
That free move gave them a pretty good shot. Be nice right about now. Explosives.
Watch the flanks. There's heavy fire in this zone.
Oof. Okay, as unlucky as I got a second ago, I think I just got lucky there. Try and headshot the one that is mind-linked. Yeah, that'll take them both out. Malik supposedly can see a target, but I don't actually see a target. So I guess I'll overwatch with her.
Yes, Commander.
Reloading. Nick's gonna need to reload. Time for Brian to reload. She still can see some sort of imaginary target.
Heading out.
I think we've just got a game glitch there.
We're green to go.
Overwatch, aye aye.
Yeah, they're right inside.
Do you hear something?
Roger, I've got my eyes on.
Malik can still see the fictional alien soldier.
Headed there now. Eyes peeled, Commander.
I think
position confirmed.
Up. This is kind of dangerous, but good.
Got it covered.
They're gonna have to come out to engage us. Says she's still got eyes on one
now.
Of them. Looks like there's just one of them to be had. Oh no, there's
target
a group of
acquired.
Thin men at the back.
Find some new cover.
So
that
she
looks like the primary
can see
power source
four
for
plus
craft.
Her imaginary
one.
One
has it a guess as to the amount of power it would have to be generating to propel that ship. I'd watch your fire down there. That equipment could be highly unstable.
Move her all the way to here with her second move. See if we can lay a little bit of a trap for them.
Roger that. Scanning.
There we go. Sounded good.
Missed the target.
Let's hope that his poison cloud, if he dies there, doesn't just drop in my face.
They're shifting their attack.
He can't see. How can he not see? Yeah. I just gotta hope the poison cloud is small enough it won't catch Nick. Yeah. Cover with a sniper rifle. She can still see the imaginary one. Try this again. Oh, there we go. This is working so well at the moment, I think we'll just keep it up.
I've got my eyes on.
Come get some.
And if they don't move out here, I think I'm just gonna open that door.
I think I heard something.
Yeah, let's get Brian all the way over here.
Time to motor.
Commander.
Little buggy silhouette there. I mean, they may be trying to scoop around the side.
Shh. I think I heard something.
I think it's time to open that door. Alright, so we got a 33% shots.
Damn it! Missed the target.
Roger. I've got my eyes on. I feel.
Alright, let's see what happens when we move up. He's gonna take a slightly different piece of cover. Take a shot at Varsha.
Taking fire over here.
Destroy our cover. Just get the other one to move. Uh oh.
Damn, that was close.
We're gonna call that exceptionally lucky.
On the move.
Took another 33% shot there.
Target's still up.
Alright, so. Nick doesn't have a great number of options here. But I think my best one is going to be to dash him as far as I can. Maybe to here.
10-4.
Roger.
And I don't think he's going to move up enough to be relevant, but maybe. He's just gonna go around and try and take a shot at Nick.
Incoming fire!
I mean, maybe that one will not want to be flanked. Or he'll just run directly at me screaming. That's something. Whew! Actually see anybody. Nick will die from the poison if I leave him there. I think I've got to move back to here and heal myself.
Got it covered.
Overwatch. She really doesn't have a good line on anybody.
Roger that. Scan.
Yeah, I guess we overwatch and hope for the best. That'll work. It's pretty close to the best we can expect. He's gonna take another shot at Nick. Oh! But maybe Brian will take him out right here. That'll do.
All mission objectives complete.
Nice! I don't think we could have played that any better. Kim Cook taking a crit from a floater. I mean, that's just kinda how it goes sometimes. Unfortunately, that means that we are heavy on snipers and medics, but our only heavy and our only assault have both died. I think. There might still be another heavy. So, we have an officer training school as an option, and give us a bigger squad size. Both, Corporal, now Squatty Brian Ring has been promoted to Corporal, and we've got Sergeant Nick Andrea earning the nickname Ace. We will be changing that nickname. We're going to give Brian squad sight so he can shoot at anything any of his buddies can see. And yes, we are going to give Sergeant Andrea the field medic ability. Let's see, we got a UFO power source, thin man autopsy, because we got some thin man corpses. We fought them before, but that was in Japan, where we didn't survive. We had to bug out. Got some Illyrium, alien alloys. Yeah, a bunch of stuff we can sell. So, yeah. Alright, despite the fact that we lost yet another individual, I'm feeling pretty okay about that mission. Take Sergeant Andrea and customize him. I'm going to give him a more appropriate nickname. He will now be known as Deacon, even though he is wounded in medbay for the next 21 days. Ouch. So it looks like we're going to have double sniper, and we're going to have a new rookie. We may have to start ordering more rookies. But I think that's going to be a good spot for me to call it for the evening. Appreciate everyone tuning in. Looking forward to turning this thing around, fighting the good fight. We had a pretty successful mission, even though we lost a soldier. I mean, that's just XCOM for you. You're going to lose people. Hopefully, you're going to be able to promote more than you lose, at least enough to fight. The fight for Earth is not quite dead yet. However, victory is by no means assured. I could get 10, 12, 20 episodes in on this series, and the result could be that the Earth is lost. Would not be the first time I'd lost at Classic difficulty. I have beaten the campaign once. Once on Classic Iron Man and once on Classic Normal. So I guess that'd be twice total. But we'll see how this live playthrough goes. Appreciate everybody who tuned in. And I'll talk to everyone later.